tight lap session. He was the fastest car overall. Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh in that messy electric car number 7. Oh, a little bit hard into turn number 3, entering the bottom of turn 4. The car just about got out from under him. Race monitor is up and running. And even with the bobble, that was a good lap. 12.541. And he picks it up to a 4.21. 12.421 for Donald McIntosh in that Blunt Motorsports car number 7. Chad Ogle, former winner here at Volunteer with the Clash, car number 10. He was 9th overall with a 12 and a 9.87. Car number 10 exiting turn number 4, the white flag coming down. A 13.032, just a tick off of his hot lap speed of 12.987. Exiting turn number 3, to the bottom of turn number 4, Chad Ogle in the 10 ride. 6.75, picked it up just over a half a second on lap number 2. So he's within 2/10 of a second from the fast time of Donald McIntosh. 12.421, that's what they're chasing. Car number 11 on the speedway of Marion, Virginia, it's Travis Greer. Good to have our Virginia friends from over in the southwest corner coming down to Interstate to be with us tonight. Car number 11 of Travis Greer. He'll be followed by Anthony Sanders. Travis Greer, 13.089. Anthony Sanders out of line. Mark Douglas coming out before him, so car number 52 is up next. Knoxville, Tennessee, car number 52, Mark Douglas on the speedway. Coming to get his white flag lap. The car came out from under him. That's exiting turn number 3 at the entrance of 4. Let's see where he falls in. 12.770, 12 and a 7.70. For Douglas, here he is entering turn number 3. This time, a good exit off of turn number 4. They'll pick it up on lap number 2. Oh, my goodness, what a lap. 12 and a 3.81. He's the fastest time so far tonight. So a 12.381 puts the 52 car up on the top of the scoreboard. Just about a half of a tenth of a second over Donald McIntosh. So Mark Douglas looking for his first Carolina Clash victory here in these good old dog days of August for round number 5 of the Carolinas. Tennessee Clash at the Gap. Checkered flag Anthony Sanders with a 13 and a 5.09. 13.509. If you're following us on Periscope, welcome aboard. We are broadcasting live on the Twitter feed. The Periscope is on. And we're giving it to you live. Joey Coulter, he's got an in-car camera on the Periscope feed. So we'll see how Joey looks out there on the speedway. He's got to pick it up here on lap number 2. He's 13 and a 5.70. 13.570 for Joey Coulter out of Union Grove, North Carolina. Here he comes down the front straightaway. And he'll move up into the 4th position. Picked it up just under a second. At the 12.741. Carolina Clash Series points leader, the young star out of Rock Hill, South Carolina, Ben Watkins, in that Longhorn Racer, won Fayetteville Motor Speedway last Saturday night, car number 16. Still trying to find his way around the high banks of the gap. Here he comes, car number 16 of Ben Watkins. 13.516, 13.516. So coming through 3, trying to get the car to sit down. Buck and Bronco off of turn number 3, Watkins, 13.190, 13 and a 1.90. Ross White, car number 0, out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Good to have our folks from down in Knoxville coming up to race with us tonight. He's on the track, entering turn number 3, up on the black strip, coming through the top of the banking, turn number 3, white flag going down for Ross. Whoa, third place fastest, 12.633 for Ross White in the 0 out of Knoxville. And he'll stay in that third place position with a 13.321 on lap number 2, so he slowed it down on the second run around. But a 12.633, big time for Ross White. Here comes the most recent winner here of the class here at the Gap, Vic Hill, car number 1. That Land Air Transport from Mosheim, Tennessee, coming down the front straightaway now to take the white flag, Vic Hill. And he is in the third position, 12.581. 12.581 sets it down to the bottom of turns three and four, up to the top of the banking checkered flag. Will he have enough to get under that third place position? No, he will stay in third with a 12.581, a 6.32 on the second lap around. So the best time came up on lap number one. Mark Douglas, the car they're chasing, car number 52, 12 and a 3.81. He is the fastest car so far. Donald McIntosh is second. Vic Hill in third. Ross White and Chad Ogle rounding out your top five. Talbot, Tennessee, it's Forrest Trent in that 101 car pulling double duty tonight with Joey Coulter in the Clash Series with the Sportsman Crates here tonight. 13-4-1-5, 13-4-1-5. Putting him in the ninth place position. Mike McCarter just set down a fast time of 4.62, 12 and a 4.62 for the Tennessee native, car number 51, through the turns three and four, coming for the checkered flag, looking to be fast. Here he comes, and he's going to stay in the third place position, but a much better lap on lap number two than the first one. 12, a 4, 41. So we are within 0.07 of a second from first back to the third position with Vic Hill with a 5.81, just 0.2 off the pace. Here's Tommy Kerr, that number four car. Blunt Motorsports team out of Maryville, Tennessee. Car number four over into turn number one. Takes the green flag. Oh, he come down off of turn four with a flame fury coming to the white flag, checkered flag going down. Fourth fastest in a 12.505. Mark Douglas, Donald McIntosh, Mike McCarter, Tommy Kerr, Vic Hill, Ross White, Chad Ogle, Joey Coulter, Travis Greer. That's the top nine on the Speedway. Ben Watkins rounding out the top 10. Dale Ball, the Limestone Tennessee driver, car number two, out of turn number three. .13.494, one of the drivers, not quite the amount of horsepower that some of these other guys do, but Dale giving it his best shot. Dale Ball, checkered flag coming down for him. 13.388, 13 and a 3.88. Ellery Leake on the Speedway. Driver, another one of the Knoxville, Tennessee campaigners. Car number 34, checkered green flag coming out. Ninth overall, 12.885, 12.885. Ellery Leake, car number 34, coming through turn number three. Only a few more to go. Kevin Wilson, Doug Sanders, and the newcomer, Brian Hendricks. Another one of our Knoxville drivers. A good field of cars from down in the Knoxville area coming up to run tonight. Kevin Wilson, one of the North Carolina campaigners. Third in the point standings, car number 618. .13.666, Kevin Wilson. One of three drivers with perfect attendance, including this guy, the veteran from down in Gaston County, North Carolina, Doug Sanders. Former winner of the Carolina Shrine Race, 1991-92 winner of that Shrine event, this coming Tuesday night, August the 11th, the Carolina Speedway in Gastonia, North Carolina, the 43rd annual Shrine 100. A 35-lap Carolina Clash main event for $3,000 to win. Doug Sanders going to loop it around, exiting turn number three. So hold that 5, be main for your sportsman division. So a lot of racing yet to do tonight and a lot of racing yet to do in the 2015 season here at The Gap. Follow them online on Facebook, the social media pages, both Facebook and Twitter, the Gap Facebook site, giving you all the latest updates and information about race day events that go on here at your beautiful hometown racetrack in Greenville, Tennessee. So thanks, folks, for being out tonight. Brian Hendricks coming on the scoreboard. He will have a lap time of 13.567. 13.567. And that is the bottom of the pack of the cars that have taken time tonight. See if he can jump up a couple here on this second run around. Yep, he's going to stay there. So he's 17th overall. 13 and a 5.16. 13 and a 5.16. Car number 5. He'll be joined by Anthony Sanders, the Smithfield Barbecue Langley's Collision Center car number 421 out of Spartanburg, South Carolina. Forrest Tran out of Talbot, Tennessee in the 101. He'll roll off from the 15th position. Kevin Wilson out of Stoneville, North Carolina, car number 618, third in the point standings. He goes from 14th. Well, Johnson City, Tennessee's Dale Ball, car number 2, will start from 13th. Points leader Ben Watkins rolls off 12th tonight after some handling problems in the qualifying session. The Sandwood Company, car number 16, starts in 12th. Marion Greer is 11th out of Marion, Virginia. Travis Greer. Ellery Leak out of Knoxville. Joey Coulter out of Union Grove, North Carolina. They're on Periscope tonight. Follow him online if you have a Twitter feed. Download the Periscope app. And Race Monitor is up and running. Here comes the front row of Mark Douglas and Donald McIntosh. We'll wait for the call to see if this one stands. We may bring them under caution on the back straightaway if they decide to do so. Everything looks green and clear so far. Caution is out. Nope, knew that wasn't going to go. Front row did not come all the way off the corner. The exit of turn number 4, that front row has to start evenly. A little bit too early on the... All right, lights out around the speedway as we get reset here. No go on the official start. Front row didn't bring the clearing all the way out of the corner. And so we'll try it again. Matt McCarter, Tommy Kerr, Vic Hill, Ross White in that third row. Chad Ogle, Doug Sanders from row number 4 as the restart for the first lap around Volunteer Speedway. Green is out, underway, and Mark Douglas quickly takes off. Donald McIntosh down to the bottom. Here comes teammate Tommy Kerr out of the inside of turn number 3. To the bottom. Exiting turn 4, Douglas. Let's get them all across, gentlemen. Lap number 1 goes down in the books. Vic Hill in 5th, Mike McCarter up in 4th. Tommy Kerr trying to keep his advance at 51 car down on the bottom. Here they come for lap number 2. Tommy Kerr hangs on to the 3rd place position as we chase down Mark Douglas in car number 52. Sorting out back through the field, watching the cars come up to speed. Ellery Link battling points leader Ben Watkins as Mark Douglas, Donald McIntosh pull away by about 5 car lengths, separated back between the 2. Mike McCarter in 3rd. Vic Hill running in the 4th spot. Tommy Kerr fading back to 5th, losing a couple of spots on that last transition around turns 1 and 2. Lap number 5 getting set to go up on the board quickly. The leader starting to dangle with the back of the field as Vic Hill starts to make a move on the inside of Mike McCarter going to turn 1. They'll quickly work the back of the Brian Hendricks number 5 car. Kevin Wilson, Travis Greer, Anthony Sanders. All of those cars getting set to get buried up into traffic with the leader. Go to turn number 1. Oh, and he runs right in the back of the 5 car. Pushes him up the hill. Here's Donald McIntosh trying to close some gap on him. We will quickly get tightened up as they work the traffic here on lap number 6. Douglas shoots up the racetrack. McIntosh tried to go down low. Not enough down there to get that car momentum off the corner. Douglas now up underneath the Kevin Wilson, who is fast on the outside, trying to keep himself a lap down. Douglas will clear for the lap car of Kevin Wilson back to the turn 3. Vic Hill on the inside of Matt McCarter. He got loose coming off of turn number 2. Travis Greer down low, inside slow car number 11, laps down, coming off turn number 4. He'll take it into the pit area. Donald McIntosh trying to get around Kevin Wilson, but Vic Hill's closing in on him. Dale Ball is the car next up in the sights as he passes to the inside of Forrest Trent. Now Mark Douglas continues to click him off one at a time as we close in on the first 1/4 of the race. 10 laps complete, now 11 down, 29 laps to go for Mark Douglas flag to flag so far, but Vic Hill is the man on the move. He's caught Donald McIntosh, who is working the lap cars off of turn number 3. Wow, Mark Douglas is caught up behind Dale Ball. Cannot make the pass on that lap car. Coming down the front straightaway. Battle for second. Vic Hill underneath the McIntosh. They're tied up behind Big A. Anthony Sanders over in turn two. Leader now behind Doug Sanders coming down the front straightaway as they put another lap on Brian Hendricks at five car. He's got lap cars on both sides of him. Sanders now, they'll split shot down the back straightaway. Douglas will clear. He's got some free air in front of him. And now that fierce battle for second, they'll have to maneuver it with two more cars and then some open ground in front of them. McIntosh, he'll turn the car hard down the hill and bring Vic Hill. Mac McCarter, he's got his momentum recaptured. The 51 car. So three cars in pursuit. Caution on the Speedway. First caution of the night, lap number 15. It'll be for Brian Hendricks, the car who started the shotgun of the field. He will be the first car to bring up the caution flag here at the Gap. Drivers compete on here and the Carolina Class Series and at Volunteer Speedway. So Hoosier and American Race are the two-time brands that sponsor Carolina Class Racing for the 2015 season. I want to thank Renegade Racing Fuels for their Rookie of the Year, who is also Ben Watkins. So he will be a Rookie of the Year champion this season and potentially the Carolina Class champion once they race at Cherokee Speedway on October the 24th. Annual Blue-Gray Race. Wrap up the 2015 campaign. Here they come through turns three and four, sitting on lap number 15, and Mark Douglas out by himself. He will restart from that double file. Now Vic Hill slides up under the back end of McIntosh. That provoked him to get to the inside of Matt McCarter, the 51 car. So that slow start on that outside lane, Vic Hill was trying to get around McIntosh. They get together. McCarter had a mid on him, and everything sorts out. Mark Douglas back out in the lead. McIntosh, Vic Hill, Michael Carter, and Ben Watkins now up into the fifth place position. Trouble, turn four. Ellery Leak spins the 34 car down to the inside of turn number four. So caution out quickly once again. So the advancement of car number 16. All right, we're back to racing, watching that battle between Hill and McIntosh. And the restart that he wanted just took place. Now Ben Watkins moves into fourth. McIntosh now back to third as Vic Hill starts to climb his way closer and closer to your race leader, Mark Douglas. A couple more restarts like that, he's going to have his wishes come true. Really, man, let's see if that lap time. Look at Douglas now starting to get closer and closer to that 12 flat mark. A 198 just got laid down by car number 52. 12-198, and it is time to go, my man. It is really time to go because your hands are getting ready to be laying there full over off of turn number three as Hill closes in on the leader and halfway next time. Vic Hill would be looking for his second ever Clash win, and he just knocked down a 103, so a 12-103, the fastest car of the night. He's on the inside. Here in the second half of the race, that one car has come to life. Up behind the six. Oh, trouble on the front straightaway. Joey Coulter right in front of the field, and Wilson had nowhere to go. I mean, there was nowhere to go. They could not get slowed down fast enough. Vic Hill got tagged. It was minimal, just a little bit of contact, but you know, these things are so engineered to the nearest degree. I mean, you can't do anything. You can't really touch these things in any fashion. So any kind of contact like that can move a bar, it can move a link or anything could happen. So let's see if that has affected. Lap down that's quicker than his best, then Vic will come back the lap later and lay down one that's quicker than his best. So we need to watch how these two are doing.
Well, we got the one to go from the flag stand on this Delaware double file restart, and of course Douglas is going to be out front and leading the rest of the field.
Now McCarter had issues in the qualifying. After qualifying, they were under the hood of his 51 car. Apparently they got everything squared away, and understand they were having maybe some transmission issues on car number 7, as Rich Allen was doing some tweeting earlier. And follow them on Periscope, too. That's a neat little app that's on for live video. So anyway, we're back to it. Now, that was a good restart for McIntosh. He was able to clear Vic Hill, who may not have been up on the wheel as the green light came on. Look out. Tommy Kerr, Chad Ogle get together. Everybody's okay. Down the front straightaway, Mike McCarter and Ben Watkins exchange a spot. Now Vic Hill slides up the track, and there could be the result of that contact on that most recent caution when he and Wilson got together trying to avoid the Joey Coulter car who had spun on the front straightaway. Now Mark Douglas checked back out. Douglas in second is McIntosh. Now Vic Hill hanging on to that third place position. Doug Sanders down pit road.
You know, it looks like Vic Hill's trying to make a little bit of a comeback as he dips kind of low in the turns. I think he's starting to kind of figure that car out from the little bit of damage he may have sustained here on the front straightaway. He's kind of figured out maybe how to handle that machine, and he's starting to mount a comeback on Tommy Kerr here as they come off in the front straightaway.
Yeah, I think he was just maybe seeing if there was anything major wrong with it. Once he figured out this thing will go fast forward, I'm going to put the hammer down. Now, he is caught up behind McIntosh. He's on the inside of him. Those two have been going at it for most of the night. Except when that restart a moment ago, when Vic Hill was able to get around McIntosh, the Dawsonville driver in car number 7. But, boy, Mark Douglas loves to see that open air behind him. Not open air in front of him right now, but safely around the Hendricks car number 5. He'll have Kevin Wilson and a few more up in front of him as we close in on lap number 30 and 10 to go when they come back around.
And it looks like Hendricks is slowing down on the apron as he's going to roll his down pit road as well, coming off the fourth turn.
Now, the importance of these last 10 laps, any restarts will be single file according to series rules. So if we get a caution here, the restart will be single file, no double file behind him. But it's not going to matter as long as it stays green for Tennessee's Mark Douglas. Now just over a third of a track lead for the 52 car. You'll probably start seeing him be a little bit more patient as we start to negotiate these lap cars, knowing that we are just about 7 laps remaining. Well, maybe not. He's just powered by Dale Ball. He wants to get as far away from Donald McIntosh as possible. He'll have Joey Coulter up in front of him with 5 laps to go next time by. So good battle between those first, second through fifth place positions. They're all right there together. McIntosh, Vic Hill, that car seems to have gone away from him just a little bit. Matt McCarter now challenging him as we are 4 laps remaining for race leader Douglas coming off of turn 4. So with that big of a lead, you can think he could just pace his way around and not make any risky moves on these lap cars. Let them settle it amongst themselves. Just hang back or, oh, there's the caution. Matt McCarter has spun at the top of turn at number 3. So, uh-oh. Car 51 looping it around, backing it into the fence up a top turn number 3 as the emergency lights come on around the racetrack.
Lancaster or Lancaster?
Well,
I think we had this discussion last time you were here.
We did, and Doug Gilliwater used to call it, what was he say, Lancaster, I think it was. Here we go. Green is out, a good restart for Mark Douglas, putting some distance between himself and Vic Hill. That car continues to fade on him, and now Ben Watkins has come through 9 positions to run into third spot. Vic Hill, he'll cut off the one's entrance of turn number four. Now Watkins to third. Hill's going to skate back up the racetrack, and Ogle now into fourth as Tommy Kerr battles a very, very ill-handling Vic Hill, number one machine. White flag next time by Douglas. One lap to go. Here comes the one lap rag for Mark Douglas, car number 52. So in the past, our newest winners on the series come from Volunteer Speedway, and tonight is no different. Knoxville, Tennessee's Mark Douglas wins round five of the Clash at the Gap.
To our points leader, this has got to be like a win for you for what that car looked like in qualifying, and then work yourself from 12th place all the way to third. What a run for Ben Watkins.
Oh, man, it was that was a fight right there. You know, we got behind there at the beginning of the night. But, man, I got to give it to my crew guys. Didn't give up, you know, just worked on it. You know, and we just put it together. I got to give all the glory to God. Thank him. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. But, man, my hat's off to these guys as well.
All right, the car looked like it got better as the race went on.
Yeah, it did. We kind of gambled on the right rear tire, and it paid off at the beginning and kind of went there later. And just luckily we were to manage, you know, the third place, and we'll take it.
There you go. Good run. Good finish. Best finish here at the Gap for Ben Watkins, coming from 12th to finish third. Lap on lap number 22. That was a fast lap around. You put around this racetrack a 12.198. Vic Hill had a 103 right behind you. It seemed like when you would get a fast lap, he would have the fast lap. Then you'd get the fast lap, and then he'd get the fast lap. Good race car early. Kind of settled in for second overall.
We had a good car. I think our tire choice was a little too hard on the right rear, but my guys make so many good calls. I can't be hard on them, so awesome race car night. I can't thank Larry Garner and Blunt Motorsports, all our sponsors, Stowers Cat, Tennessee RV, everybody that makes this racing possible. I'm so blessed to be able to drive this thing. Man, what a fast racetrack tonight.
It did, and it very much got faster as the race went on. It appeared from a 381 in qualifying to a 198 in the race.
Yeah, no doubt. It was definitely a hammer down, hold on as fast as you could go, but awesome night. Congratulations to Mark Douglas. He drove a great race.
All right. Well, we're going to head over to talk to him now. Donald McIntosh coming home second in that 7 car. All right. He's getting ready to get the big check. He's got the belt already in hand. We have crowned a bunch of new winners on our series, and you are going to be the newest new winner of Carolina Clash Racing here at Volunteer. Congratulations to car number 52, Mark Douglas, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, everybody, for coming out. I'd like to thank all my sponsors, C. Laney & Sons Construction, McLean Speed Shop, Rocket Race Cars, David Bryant for helping me a lot through the whenever I got started and all that stuff. I really appreciate a lot for him. And Dad and everybody that helps me, and brother, and everybody's got a part of it. It's hard to race anymore. It's just everything costs so much, and we're just out here digging, trying to race to put on a show for the fans.
Where does this one rank? And you've won races before. This one's got to be pretty special for you.
Yeah, it's a long time coming. We've been in a drought for I don't know, probably 2 years, I guess, or maybe a little longer. We won a lot of races up here, and it just brings back memories. I'm just finally glad to put one in victory circle for a change, not have bad luck.
All right, well, definitely that last caution was probably in your mind going, what, why now?
Yeah, I just like, man, not four to go. It's pretty much a bottom middle groove. It's just going to be hard for, I think McIntosh might have been second, I'm not for sure, or Vic, one of the two. But, I just said, well, if I just hit my marks, don't let it push, or I should be okay. So it all worked out, and like I said, I appreciate all the fans coming out and supporting Volunteer Speedway and supporting us in the racing.
All right, congratulations, Volunteer. Let's hear it for your winner tonight. Let's hear it for him. Mark Douglas is your winner, and thank you, Speedway Videos. Get it online. Go to talk to them at Speedway Videos. They will have the replay, and watch this car come to victory lane for the Clash at the Gap, $4,000 for Mark Douglas. Congratulations, race fans. Give him one more hand of applause.